You've no doubt heard the news about chromium in drinking water across the country. Here's what the city of Bend is doing to make sure our water supply is completely safe and free of any contamination.
In Bend, we can be very proud of the water that we have. And one of the things that we can be proud of is that we know that it's clean and we know that it's safe. And we know that because we regularly test that water.
The city of Bend has a laboratory to do three things primarily. That is, one, test the wastewater, two, test the water, but also the two different sources of water. We have both the groundwater source and the surface water source. Between 38 and 39,000 tests are done on an annual basis in this laboratory. 80 tests are done every week for bacterial samples in the water system alone. In addition to that, there's other samples collected on both the water, the surface water source, and the groundwater source, depending on various schedules for different elements.
Municipalities, water utilities, are required to sample by regulatory agencies, the EPA, based on federal Safe Water Drinking Act, and through the State of Oregon Department of Health Services.
The sampling here in the city of Bend is really split up amongst two different groups. The laboratory obviously does a good share of our sampling, but in addition to that, we also have operations staff who are trained to take samples and who do so on a regular basis in the field.
It's been in the news that one of the water companies here in town, chromium, was found. Well, that has brought a highlight to the community of how safe is our water. So I've had many people come to me and say, is it safe? And we're testing for dozens and dozens of elements, including chromium, and testing thousands of times throughout the year to make sure our water stays safe.
The EPA requires the city of Bend and water utilities to test for up to 80 elements of concern, compounds of concern. Some of those are synthetic organic compounds, such as pesticides, herbicides, like glyphosate, which is Roundup. Other inorganic compounds, chromium is one of them, barium, cadmium, zinc, lead, copper. We look for volatile organic compounds, benzene, toluene, ethylbenzene, xylenes.
Two words folks here in the city of Bend have heard recently are cryptosporidium and chromium. Cryptosporidium is one of the reasons we are building a surface water treatment project. Two, the word you've heard lately is chromium. Chromium is an element that is found naturally here in a volcanic rock within in this region here in central Oregon and can get into the water supplies. We measure for total chromium and we have never exceeded the EPA limits for chromium.
We are testing for cryptosporidium on a monthly basis up at our source water. And we have found cryptosporidium spore sites in our surface water, very minute levels. The majority of the time it comes back non-detect, but we have found cryptosporidium, one oocyst per 10 liters.
Cryptosporidium comes from two different sources. It can come from animal waste as well as human waste. In our watershed, we have both who frequent that area. We have elk, we have beaver. In addition to that, we have a lot of hikers in that area. Those are two ways they can be introduced into our water supply.
We have found cryptosporidium levels up in our water source at extremely low levels.
The scientific benefits to having a dual source water system are this. If you have any characteristics that may impact the water quality, whether it's your groundwater or source water, we have a second source of water to go to.
The advantage of having that dual source of water is that if something did get into, say, the well water or the surface water, we have the ability to switch from one to the other. And so that dual source gives us the reliance that we're gonna have safe drinking water in Bend for ourselves and our grandkids and great-grandkids.
Testing water and wastewater is very important to our citizens. For one, we have to ensure that the water that they're consuming is safe and potable. Two, we also have to ensure that the wastewater that we're putting back into the ground in Central Oregon is also safe.